What is education abroad, you ask? Education abroad is a chance for undergraduate students, that's you, to study in another country while earning academic credit at UW-Platteville. If you have a sophomore credit standing with at least a 2.5 GPA, are a full-time student, and have good academic standing, then you qualify for study abroad. Participating in an education abroad program offers a range of benefits to students during their college career. It truly is a life-changing experience and offers personal growth by making you more adaptable, open-minded, and independent. You learn by interacting with locals, learning the language, and immersing yourself in the culture, all while becoming interculturally competent. Approximately 150 students from UW-Platteville from all majors study abroad every year. Studying abroad opens doors for continued growth for the rest of your life. Having education abroad experience on your resume gives you an advantage over other applicants.
I believe that this has opened doors for me professionally because, like, employers always look for people who will go the extra distance and build, like, relationships around the world kind of thing. They'll even be looking for people who took the extra step to study abroad because that's, like, them going to this different place that's, like, has their own, like, style of learning, different people that you have to communicate with, and, like, you're essentially just building a skill. So I took marine biology and ecology. Both classes gave me, like, hands-on, like, experience. Like, I got to work in the field right away instead of having to, like, take stuff, like, samples out of jars, which we do here in Platteville. Like, I actually got to go in the environment and take what I wanted.
Sometimes, it may seem that it will be too expensive to study abroad. Well, do not fret. Financial aid applies. There are also several scholarships to apply for specifically for students who are studying abroad. One such scholarship is the UW-Platteville International Study Scholarship, which you can receive for both short and long-term programs. In addition, there are other scholarships and grants available, such as the Pioneering Abroad Scholarship and others based on the region you will be studying in.
I have quite a few scholarships that I was able to receive over the years, and I knew that I was going to be studying abroad, so I saved them up. And by working over the summer, I also had money extra, and I also received the Platteville Study Grant. I paid the finances to study abroad just through Platteville. It was a pretty simple process. It just came up on pass and I paid for it. It was pretty cut and dry. Platteville was pretty helpful while trying to find out where I should go to find other sources of funds while going to studying abroad. So that was pretty helpful. I would say to plan for travel. Like, before you leave, think of some places you would really like to go, and then maybe say, oh, I want to have two other big trips. Just have that idea going into it, because you know you're going to travel a lot and you're going to meet people and, hey, let's go here, let's go there. I mean, I went to Budapest, like, I decided a week before, and I just booked a flight and went.
The UW-Platteville Education Abroad Office offers a variety of options. There are UW-Platteville Education Abroad programs, exchange programs, and short-term faculty-led programs. You can even do an internship or student teaching abroad. From Australia to England, Japan to Spain, we've got it all. Our programs offer a range of support and structure, and the costs and length of the programs vary depending on what type of program you choose. There is a program for everyone.
The short-term faculty-led was a really good program for me because I was able to study abroad over the summer and be back in time to take summer classes at Platteville, and it didn't mess up my graduation date or different prerequisites for classes. I wasn't worried about how they would transfer. For the short-term faculty-led program, it's typically 3 credits, and it counts for your international education credit and an additional one usually, so mine double counted for that and for my history. So that was really convenient because I didn't have either of those fulfilled yet, so.
What do you do abroad? First and foremost, you are there to be a student. Besides that, the options are limitless. You could complete an internship, volunteer, participate in a sports team or student organization, go on day and weekend excursions, or travel during your breaks. Immersing yourself in the culture will provide you with the best study abroad experience. Even if you go to an English-speaking country, there will be some exciting cultural and linguistic differences. And don't worry if you're not fluent in another language. Unless you decide to take your classes in a foreign language, your classes will be instructed in English. However, if you are a Spanish major studying in Spain, you should probably be taking at least one class in Spanish.
Well, studying abroad with Spanish was really nice because you get to actually practice it. When here you're in a classroom, you try and practice, but you go and speak English when you leave the classroom. In Spain, you're surrounded by Spanish, so it kind of forces you to use it daily and use it all the time without even thinking about it. I studied abroad twice. I studied in Spain and in Barcelona for summer of 2014, and I studied in Prague, Czech Republic, this past summer. I took 3 semesters of Spanish when I was here at UW-Platteville. I just had an interest in Spanish, and I thought it'd be a good skill to take with all the diversity in our country. And then I decided to go to Spain to practice my Spanish. Both of my classes were in English, and then when I went to Prague, I actually took 2 classes in English as well. You may be worried about studying abroad in a different country with a different language, but it's actually not as bad as you'd think. A lot of the classes are taught in English, and a lot of people know English worldwide.
If you plan ahead, studying abroad will not delay your graduation. Step 1. Talk to your academic advisor right away and tell them that you want to study abroad. Step 2. Figure out when and how long you would like to go abroad. Are you planning on going for a semester or a year? Or would studying abroad during spring, summer, or winter break work better for your schedule? Step 3. Work with your academic advisor to decide what classes you need to take abroad. Step 4. Meet with your education abroad advisor to discuss your program options. Now, this is where you take action. Interested in studying abroad? I mean, who wouldn't be? There is a whole world out there just waiting to be explored. Visit the Education Abroad office in Royce Hall. You can call us at 608-342-1726 or send any questions you have to studyabroad@uwplatt.edu. You can also meet with an Education Abroad intern for peer advising or set up an appointment with your Education Abroad advisor. If not now, when? Your journey with Education Abroad awaits.